The scope of the station as it stands now and as you see here today was developed through the middle of the 2000s, and the vision was very much defined by the constraints that we've got here. So at Broadgate we have a below ground ticket hall, and at Moorgate we have a ticket hall at ground floor. So it's very much looking at the transition of spaces between there and creating a space that people really want to use. It's intuitive, people feel safe, but also it's visually exciting as people move through it. Building underground here is probably one of the most complex stations on the line. We have a lot of existing infrastructure, existing underground railway lines, things like post office railway, culverted old rivers, sewers. So it's been very much like almost a piece of surgery, sort of where you can push the tunnels through, create spaces, ticket halls. And that's very much governed also by the buildings that sit over the top. So we've had to, where possible, avoid going underneath buildings as well. It's more about functionality. It's more about creating interesting, exciting spaces where we can get light in, where we can create an architecture that is within the volumes, is interesting for people to move through. And it's very much going through a sequence of spaces, both rectilinear spaces, quite low ticket halls, into large boxes that have escalators in, and then into a network of tunnels which take you down to the platforms. The challenges were very much dictated by where we could run tunnels, where we could avoid going underneath buildings, avoid affecting buildings sort of substructure, below ground structure. And so we've sort of going from where we could build ticket halls at Broadgate, it's limited by where we could get a ticket hall below ground in the street. And then at Moorgate, the ticket hall sits over the top of the existing Metropolitan Circle lines, and then that has an office building that's being built over it. So it was then a question of where you could feed tunnels to connect in with the running tunnels of the railway down below. So the railway is approximately 30 metres below ground. So the escalators and the tunnels don't just go straight, they have to go through a series of switches to be able to get down to where the running tunnels are. So we excavated a very large hole, sits below ground level, and then there's a glazed canopy that sits over the entrance. So that glazed canopy very much signals the entrance into the station, and that sits in a new public space. So the old Liverpool Street now has no traffic in it. It's a new hard landscape space, and you enter down through this canopy into the station. And then at night, the nature of it being glass, it actually glows like a lantern. So it works very well from a wayfinding point of view. The public realm at both ends of the station, what we've looked to do is enhance the public realm around the entrance to the station, give much more priority or much greater priority to pedestrians rather than traffic, move the traffic out. Earlier designs had a lot more landscaping, soft landscaping in, areas to seat, but with the large volumes of people moving through the spaces now, they're predominantly hard landscape. But what's happening along with the public realm developing there is also an ongoing program of development of the buildings either side as well. So it very much feels like a new piece of city at either end. When we design buildings, one of the sort of key sort of elements of a building is giving it an identity. So we adopted this folded concrete form. So what you see isn't an architectural lining, it is the structure. And it's formed from precast concrete panels. And we've adopted this folded form, which works structurally, gives it depth, but it also gives architectural interest. And so that motif, that appearance, we've taken through both ticket halls and then through into the escalator boxes as well, before you then go down into the tunnel network. Rather than have large flat surfaces, what we've done with the concrete, we did a great deal of testing with it. It's a reconstituted stone, so it's a mix that is based on Portland stone being the main material that's used through the traditional city buildings. And what we've added into it is mica, which gives it a little bit of sparkle. The groove, the routing was put in there to give us texture and form, and so that when you look across the surface, you read this folding of the grooves within the concrete. So it helps you read the different folds. And we did a lot of experimentation, did a lot of mock-ups, testing how this would look and how it looked with the light on it to get the right profile that gave us what we wanted. It's very much what gives the station its identity, this triangulation and this folding of the soffits. As architects, Wilkinson Air, we have a bit of a specialism in oversight developments. That's where we build over the top of stations and the like, which we're currently building, at Moorgate, the oversight at that end is very much acting as a large bridge, which we're currently building as a new headquarters for Deutsche Bank. There are other bits of infrastructure that come up through to ground level, the ventilation shafts, escape shafts, and then there are new office buildings that are wrapping around those as well. So there's quite a lot of effect by building the station that happens above ground as well. So particularly at Moorgate, we have the benefits where we've both been building the station, so we have a great deal of knowledge of what's in the ground and what's happening as a building sequence there. And then the challenge of trying to build a building over the top of it is significant, particularly in regards to protecting the asset that sits below that building. And also, as we are doing now, is that we're already using the new ticket hall there. And so it's very much about how you protect people as well. So there's a very careful program planned out as to how you build these two things in sequence and maintain access to the station below, but still carry on building the building over above. On the lower levels, this is a tunneled space. It has these totems that are set down through it that have both uplighters in, but also they provide information, wayfinding and the like. What we have down here is a line-wide language where we have a system of what are called GRC panels, glass reinforced concrete. And it's a very fluid plastic material. So what we've been able to do, unlike a lot of traditional underground tunnel linings, is that we've been able to express the flow and the curves through the spaces. It's very expressive of how people will move through the station, move through the concourse, through what we call here an adit that leads you through into the platforms themselves. Very long platforms, and they're protected, similar to the Jubilee line, they're protected with edge doors. There are a number of common components designed, industrial design components, seating and the like, bracketry. And as architects, we've been given that as a palette of materials and elements to use within our station design, but given a fairly free rein of how and where we use those. So on the floor, we use a reconstituted stone. It has a high level of granite in it. It's known as granazzo, so it's effectively a terrazzo with bits of stone within it. Very hard wearing, used quite a lot across the underground network, but we've used quite a light color. We've tried to use a light palette of materials so that the spaces feel inviting and welcoming to come into. And then the walls are lined with glass reinforced concrete, so we can take up these quite complex geometries where you go from one tunnel to another tunnel in a sort of very expressive, sort of fluid way. The deep escalator box, we wanted to very much feel like the nave of a medieval cathedral. Its scale, its volume is very similar to that. And it was very much about coming out of the tunnel network as you come up from the platforms and come out of the sort of tighter tunnel network. We wanted to enjoy the sort of excitement of coming into this large space. We worked very hard to move the props from within that space that quite often dominate these deep underground spaces. And so you could enjoy the volume of the space with the folded concrete forms to the soffit running through from the ticket halls. And then on the wall, we've put a patterned cladding that's very expressive of sort of almost like geological layering. But we all through in similar way with the soffit is very much looking at sort of strong geometric lines. So there's a richness to the spaces as you move through them. We've shared quite a lot of knowledge as the designs have developed to see how the different architects have developed their stations and the language they've taken through into those. There's some common components like the GRC cladding, but then in spaces like the ticket halls, we've been given quite a free rein of what we do. The client, the Crossrail body, have been very good at encouraging the architects to give their own identity to the station. And I'm very keen to see how people react to the spaces and that, you know, that they actually respond in the way that we anticipate.